it's Carl Dubler with Exasol. We're a database built for analytics, and as you're about to see, we're also built for speed. What I have for you today is a demonstration of Exasol's performance versus three of our leading competitors. Here I have four identical Power BI dashboards, each of them connected to the same data set, 4 billion rows of retail data in a star schema. Now, to test the performance of these systems, we're going to run a simple query routine on each. We'll start by switching from Arizona to Georgia, and then we'll view all the stores in Georgia. Then we're going to drill down to a specific store, and then from there, drill down to a specific category of sales in that store. Let's see which of these systems can do that routine the fastest. I'll even give our competitors here a bit of a head start. So in the bottom right-hand corner, we'll go with Snowflake first. Then we'll start in the top right-hand corner, the Amazon Redshift system, bottom left corner, Azure, Synapse, and then top left corner will be Exasol. So there you see on the Exasol system, we're drilling down into the state of Georgia. There we go. Now we're going to view all of the stores in Georgia. There they are. Then we're going to drill down to a specific store in a lovely little town in the northwest of Georgia called Dalton. And from there, drilling down into the home goods category of that store, and that's the end of the routine. Exasol did that in 29 seconds. The others are still catching up somewhere in Georgia. Now you might be wondering, is there any funny business going on behind the scenes here? And I appreciate your concern, but I can assure you this is on the level. Again, we're all using the same data set, 4 billion rows of retail data, but we've also configured these systems very close to each other. Now, we couldn't get them identical. I mean, after all, some of them are running on AWS, some of them on Azure, but we got them as close as we could. So you notice the price for the Exasol system is $7.45 an hour, up to $8 an hour for the Snowflake system. So Exasol is even at a bit of a disadvantage here too with resources, but they're all within a half dollar of being similarly configured. So as close as we could get them. It looks like Azure is getting really close there to drilling all the way down to the bottom. Come on, Azure. Almost there. There we go. You crossed the finish line, Synapse. Nice job. So what's giving Exasol the performance advantage here? Well, there's quite a few things, but let me talk about the two most important. The first is query tuning, automatic query tuning. All right, so nothing was done to these systems ahead of time. There wasn't any tuning that went on ahead of time. We didn't create an index or warm up the cache. These are cold queries off of 4 billion records. The kind of thing you'd want to do, you want to let your users do, right? Kind of explore the data on their own. You don't know where they're going to go. You don't know what they're going to ask for. So it's important that the system tune itself. Now, each of these companies will claim that they do automatic performance tuning as well. But we're different in that we tune the actual queries. We build indices on the fly to make these queries run really fast. There you go, Redshift's crossed the finish line. So query tuning, automatic query tuning is one thing that we do. The second is we're an in-memory database. And you might be thinking, well, that sounds expensive. But again, look at the price tag on these. Keep in mind that we're running on commodity hardware. Now, in this case, we happen to be running Exasol on Azure, but you could run it on AWS or Google Cloud or on-premise if you'd like to. So if you're still on-premise, you want to keep your data on-premise, none of these other systems can help you, but we can. So it's in-memory and it's automatic query tuning that's really making the difference here between Exasol and these other three competitors. And you can probably imagine some of the things you can do with that extra performance. For example, you could run ETL jobs more often so that the data's fresher. You could add more users. I mean, keep in mind here, this is only one user for each of these dashboards. What's going to happen to these other competitors when you add maybe 10 users or 100 or 300? You'll notice with Exasol that concurrency does not harm the query performance, and it doesn't boost the price like it does with some of these competitors as you add users, especially the ones that like to advertise that they are pay as you go. All right, I'm kind of looking at Snowflake here so I could wrap it up a bit. Oh, so you could do, oh, there you go, Snowflake. Good job. You crossed the finish line. So you could run ETL jobs more often. You could run more users. And of course, you can provide the kind of performance you see here for these ad hoc queries. This is what your users want to do. They want to explore the data on their own, and you need a highly performant auto-tuning system in order to do that. Well, I hope you found that demonstration of Exasol's performance advantage compelling. If you're looking for an analytics solution or a data warehouse or BI acceleration solution, you really should have Exasol on your list. Visit our website to learn more and also to try Exasol for free, on-premise or in the cloud.